Hey guys, welcome to my 3D modeling tutorial. In this video, I'll show you step by step how to create a cosmetic tube in Blender. Let's get started. The first thing you'll do is select the default camera and light and delete them. Then bring in your reference image. You can find it in the description box below. Reduce the opacity a bit. Then adjust the front view so that it gets to the middle. We can also move it back so that it doesn't interfere with the model. Then you can lock it. Add a new circle, scale it in a bit so that it aligns with the bottom of the lid. Extrude and move it up to touch the top of the lid. You can change it to X-ray mode by pressing Alt-Z. This will help us see the reference image very well. Add a loop cut and drag it down, and add another loop cut. Change select mode to edge select. Then select this edge and slide it to the left side using GG. Select the right edge and slide it to the right side as well. Switch to face select and then select the four faces. Then press Alt E to extrude along normals, just a little bit. Add a loop cut here and drag it all the way down. Then switch to face select mode. And then select all the faces around here. Then press Alt E and extrude along normals. This time you can extrude it farther than the last time. You can turn on subdivision modifier to check how it looks, and we can see that it looks awful. We can rectify that by switching to edit mode and then adding a loop cut and dragging it down. Add another loop cut and drag it up, and we can see that it's looking a bit better now. Turn it off first and then add a loop cut here. Add another one here as well. Then you can turn it back on to check and change this to 2, and we can see that it's looking really good. You can turn it down to 1 for now. Next, select the bottom edge, extrude, and then scale inside. Click on face and then grid fill. Click on the edge and then bevel with Ctrl B. And you can see that it's looking more like the reference image. Let's add a solidify modifier, drag it up, and then increase the thickness to 0.04. Change the offset from -1 to 1 as well. Then apply the modifier. Add a loop cut here on top and bevel it just a little bit so that the thickness can be a little bit more obvious. Then shade smooth, and we can see that it's looking much better. The next thing we'll do is create the body. To do that, we'll switch to edit mode, select the inner edge and press Shift D to duplicate it. Then P to separate by selection. You can rename this body and rename this lid. You can select the body, then switch to front view and X-ray mode so that you can see the body better. Scale in a bit and then drag the edge down. Extrude upwards so that it gets to the top of the lid. Extrude once again and scale out a bit. Then extrude upwards towards the Z direction. And scale out according to the reference image. Then you can scale it down in the Y direction. The next thing you'll do is zoom into this thin part. Then deselect the two edges at the ends of it. Then right click, loop tools, and then select G stretch. This straightens the edges. Now you can add the edges at the ends back into the selection. And then extrude it up, but not all the way to the end. You can deselect the edges at the ends again. Right click and then bridge edge loops. Then you can fill the three edges with F. You can add a loop cut here to make it a bit more defined. And then shade smooth. And you can see that it's looking really good. Now we are left with this pattern at the end. To create it, we'll add a cube, drag it up and scale it down. Then scale and adjust until you get a flat rectangular shape. Next, switch to edit mode and then add loop cuts. I added 40, but you can add any amount you want. You can switch to face select and then select all the faces. You can use extreme mode so that all the faces, including the back, will be selected. Then deselect the faces at the ends. Deselect and reselect the first face so that it becomes active. Click select and select checker deselect. This selects every other faces. Do the same for the other side as well. Then press Alt E to extrude along normals. And this is what we have. Add subdivision modifier to check how it looks. And we can see that it looks a bit weird. So what we'll do is add two loop cuts, one towards the top and one towards the bottom. Then right click and shade smooth. And we can see that it looks really good. From the side view of the reference image, we can see that we almost got the right shape. So what we can do is switch to the side view, add a loop cut in the middle, scale it in the Y direction a little bit, and then bevel it. And as you can see, it looks perfect. Thank you so much for sticking with me till the end. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a like and subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you in the next tutorial.